Hey guys, welcome to my first Q&A video. And you know, what better way to kick it off than around my creative residency here in Bali. Since I announced that I was selected and I've been documenting and posting about my experience, I've been getting quite a lot of questions. So I just wanted to, you know, clear up some things about the residency as well as, you know, some other random things that I got asked. Okay, so what exactly is this residency? So it's a self-directed program designed for Jamaican artists and creatives to get an opportunity to broaden your horizon, a cultural visit to Indonesia. So every year, 4 residents are selected from a competitive pool of persons, with the aim really for these residents to establish long-term cultural relationships with persons in Southeast Asia. I'll leave a link to more information on the residency. Every resident has to submit a passion project or a passion proposal or a creative project that they'll be embarking on whilst they're in Indonesia. For me, my project is a small docu series. I won't disclose much information on it right now, but look out for some content coming soon, as well as I have been vlogging and, you know, documenting my experience on social media platforms. And, you know, my project has changed slightly since I've been here, so nothing is wrong if your project changes over time, but initially you have to have a project proposal to submit or a project deck to submit in order to get chosen. So now that we've got that out of the way, I've formed most of the pertinent questions in a feature I like to call 10 questions of the Yadi in Bali. So I'm going to try to run through them very quickly so that I don't bore you guys, but in the same breath, ensure that I add as much value as I can and, you know, encourage anyone to apply for this residency as well. So let's go. So first question is, how did you hear about this creative residency? Well, long story short, I was on the road one day, saw my friend Daniel, big up yourself. And we're just talking about life, you know, talking about plans for the year, talking about growth. And, you know, she mentioned this residency to me. And, you know, I said, okay, I did my research and I said, okay, based on who I saw before, doesn't seem like this fits for me. But I said, hey, you know, in life, if you have a ticket, you have a chance. So let me give it a shot. And, you know, the rest is history. So next question is, what's the criteria to take part in the creative residency? There's no set in stone criteria per se, because I mean, the application is overseen by different individuals and they look for various things, but you have to have some body of work that you can show that you've done before or have a clear plan as to what you're going to do here in Indonesia. If you don't have any of those, then it makes no sense. So I'd encourage anyone who's thinking of applying to start thinking about your project, your creative deck from now. If you were to get the opportunity to come here, what are you going to do in your art, in your field or your art form to, you know, make some impact here and carry it back and improve your skill sets? And the next question is, what's the application process like? Honestly, I don't remember. but it was an essay type application, just answering those same questions that I asked before, and, you know, just giving an idea of what you would be doing in your residency. Next question is, do you get paid during your time? Answer is no. So what is paid for though is your accommodation and your tickets to Bali and back home, as well as you get an opportunity to go to Singapore for a few days to explore as well. But in terms of your living expenses, your day-to-day, you are responsible for that. So you have the options of either getting it sponsored or taking it from pocket or getting it from family and friends. Luckily, I was blessed to have some of it sponsored. I got assistance from some really good friends as well as some family members. So, you know, it's just really how you acquire that money to sustain. Next question is, do you need a visa to go to Bali and how long to get there? Yes and no. So you don't need a visa to enter Bali. You get a temporary visa for 30 days here but you do need a visa for transit. So it took me 3 days to get to Bali. For example, I was here from Monday and I got here on Wednesday from Jamaica. But I guess there are different ways to get here, but my way was from Kingston to US to Qatar and then to Denpasar. Oh, that rhymes. Yeah. But Denpasar is in Bali. But majority of that time lasted with layovers. So most of the time, my longest layover was from Kingston to, from New York to Qatar. And you know, I just want to big up TJ for facilitating me for the time. I really appreciated it. So yeah, that's really it. There are other ways to come, but that's my way. So you're gonna need a US visa to, you know, get here. Next question is, what's the currency like? The currency is really bad. The exchange rate is really, really bad. So for putting it in context, around 70 US dollars is about a million rupiah. So you can easily be a millionaire or a billionaire, depending on who your pocket is. My next question is the language barrier a hindrance to the experience? Yes, but not so much, because especially in Bali, a lot of persons do speak English and they have learned the language because of how the tourism industry is booming. So you can communicate with most people. The only issue is, you know, when they're discussing you, it's kind of hard to, you know, have a proper context of what's happening around you. But for the most part, English is fine. And I mean, there are apps, Google Translate, all these things. The coordinator will assist you as well. Persons are very welcoming, so it will be fine. Next question is, do I have to report to anyone on my progress? Yes, you do. So where you're staying is a very nice villa that's owned by the program coordinator. So, you know, of course, if you're having discussions with him around your project, and you know, he will assist you with getting connected with certain persons here to finish your project. So you will have to update him from time to time what's happening, because the aim really is to, you know, broaden your horizon and get your project done. And you know, this question I got recently is, where do I see myself in 5 years? I see myself well traveled. I see myself having at least 2 functional businesses that are thriving. I see myself about to get married, about to start my own family, and at that point having the trajectory to grow even further, on the right path to even grow even further, all whilst bringing people up with me and employing my friends and persons around me. Alright, so my last question, and before I ask, if you guys are liking the video and you have more questions that you want to ask about this trip, feel free to leave a comment, feel free to DM me, email me, follow me, anything. But the last question is, what is my greatest fear right now? That's a heavy question, and I think it's multiple layers. But it's mainly trying and not trying and regretting. So for example, I thought I had no chance in this, getting this residency, but I tried, I know I'm here. You know, I look at myself daily in the mirror and I'm so shocked at the fact that I actually am here and I'm actually growing and I'm actually doing this and, you know, getting all these experiences. So it's just really telling that, you know, once you conquer fears and once you just you know, try, you'll get far. You know, Will Smith always says, the greatest things in life are on the other side of fear. And this is a true testament to that. And I mean, another one would be going back to where I'm coming from. And I don't mean that in a literal sense. I mean, I love Jamaica. But going back to, I don't want to go back to how my life was a few years back. I want to always be progressing and progressing. It would be a shame to, you know, have to go back to where I'm coming from in the struggles. I'm still struggling, but, you know, getting better. And especially because my risk tolerance is very high right now, so I don't want to waste my youth. And especially with how accessible things are in today's day and age, we have no excuse as young people not to want to be the best version of ourselves and not want to just aim for greatness. So yeah, that's pretty much sums it up. But thank you so much for tuning in, guys. I am very, very excited to share my project. Just wrapping up certain things right now. But once it's done, I'll share it with everybody, and I hope that you guys will receive it. I think it's going to be really good. So yeah, thank you.